Those who man WA's last remaining fuel-powered lighthouse. The Cape Leeuwin Lighthouse sits on the extreme southwest point of Western Australia, and for nearly a century it served to warn shipping traffic of the treacherous reef and rugged coastline around Augusta. While that service will operate as before, the way in which it's done will change forever. A network team visited the lighthouse, probably the last film crew to do so, before Cape Leeuwin enters the modern world of electric power.
For the thousands of tourists who visit the Cape Leeuwin Lighthouse each year, the tall sandstone structure represents little more than a primitive guide to shipping and a subject for photographs. But for Transport Australia and the men who man her, the silent tower plays a vital role in sea and air navigation and is the focal point of its keeper's existence. For nearly 100 years, the Cape Leeuwin Light Station has maintained its solitary vigil on the southernmost tip of the southwest, winking its light with unwavering accuracy. This giant pillar is the last remaining kerosene-powered lighthouse in the state, but in a few weeks a team of electricians will move in and change a working pattern that's been in operation since 1896. Made of local sandstone, the Leeuwin Lighthouse is 39 metres high. Its signal can be seen for up to 32 kilometres out to sea. The lamp requires manpower to keep it burning. Three keepers working around the clock to ensure both the light and the radio beacon inside it are functioning correctly. For generations, the light has been tended by three keepers and their families, living in granite houses near the base of the lighthouse. Former Merchant Navy seaman Ray Pinnock has been second keeper at the Leeuwin for 9 years. It's part of his job to make sure there's enough kerosene on hand at all times, and there's only one way to get it to the top. Every day, at least 20 litres of fuel has to be taken up 176 steel stairs. And every day, that 20 litres feels like 200 once the spiral climb to the top is over. The huge lens with its myriad prisms sits in a dome at the extreme top of the lighthouse. When in operation, the lens revolves in a bath of mercury, 165 kilograms of fluid that keep the revolutions even and constant. The light itself is generated by three small burners, each with a mantle and each fed by kerosene that's vaporized in hot tubes underneath. This light, while it looks so small, throws out a million candle power. It flashes once every 7.5 seconds or twice every 15 seconds, which is approximately how long it takes for the lens to make one revolution. In effect, the light works like the hands of a huge grandfather clock, because the lens turns by a system of weights and chains hanging inside a tube that runs up the centre of the lighthouse. And like a clock, the mechanism has to be wound up. It's hardly the job that many would like, but most keepers relish the existence and the unique lifestyle to the extent that they are reluctant to leave it.
And it's the type of job that, I haven't got to rush up to work in the morning and get a bus, or I can just walk up and go on shift and come off again.
Would you say it's pretty much in your blood now?
Well, I suppose it would be, because Dad was in the Trinity House Light Service in England before I came out here.
How do you feel about night shifts and being on call? I mean, that must be pretty hard to take all the time.
Well, in a way it is, and I suppose once it goes electric, there'll be no night watches, it will be quite a godsend in a way not to have to come up on night shift. But I don't really dislike night work. I've been doing that many years now that I've got used to it, you know.
Electrification will change Leeuwin. The light will be 2 500-watt globes, and the lens will be powered by a small motor. There'll be no more carting cans up six flights of stairs, and it won't be necessary to wind up. Century-old habits that have done much to create a totally unique atmosphere.
There's something about sitting up here at night time and knowing that you're there in the middle of it sort of thing, but Then on the other hand, when it goes electric, it will be far superior light to what we've got now. And also it's getting increasingly difficult in recent years to obtain spare parts for the burner, mantles for the light. They're becoming increasingly hard to come by.
Leeuwin is also a valuable weather information source. Once every 3 hours, the keeper has to collect data like wind speed, temperature and barometric pressure, and in code, send it to Melbourne. Rainfall figures and cloud cover information are also accumulated at Leeuwin. About 5 o'clock every evening these days, the lamp is lit and it continues to burn until about 5 o'clock the next morning. Today, Ian Starling is on the light-up shift. Three flaming preheating trays filled with methylated spirits are placed beneath the three mantles. Kerosene passing over the hot metal vaporizes and burns in the mantles, creating the light. It's a matter of releasing a brake that holds the lens still and settling down with a book to wait the night shift out. Between 4:30 and 5 o'clock in the morning, the sky begins to brighten and the light is no longer needed. This morning, head keeper Ron Taylor has the job. Changeover to electricity will mean two keepers here instead of three. But while it means the end of traditional lighthouse keeping, the job has become much easier.
We get a lot of visitors down here and they wanted to keep kerosene, but you've got to bear in mind that we have to carry this kerosene up here at 20 litres a day and 185 steps. 20 litres a week, work that out yourself at the end of the week.
Do you think it'll spoil the atmosphere of the job, going electric?
Probably it would do. I would think so on that one.
Will the change mean that the lighthouse keeper himself will have more free time? I mean, you don't get a lot of it at the moment.
Oh, yes, we'll get probably more free time because, remember, now I was on this morning at 3 o'clock, had to get up at 2:15. I'm on till 6 o'clock. We're just on sunrise now, aren't we? The sun's just coming up now. I'm on till 6 o'clock. All I said to get is a break until 9. I'm on from 9 until 12 o'clock, 11:30. And then I'll be on again at 3 o'clock this afternoon, so when it does go electric, it will be 100% better for me anyway.
Will this mean then that you'll have more time for recreational activities?
Yeah, I'll have to start thinking into some new hobbies. The only hobby I have now is probably is sleeping. A bit of CB radio and a little bit of gardening, but I'll probably be able to get some fishing in now.
For the convenience of its keepers, the change to electricity at Leeuwin is probably a good thing. But it isn't without a twinge of nostalgia that they say goodbye to old customs to make room for more modern concepts. Those old concepts have operated at Leeuwin since the late 1800s. It now remains to be seen if today's ideas can stand the same test of time.
Well, the end of an era. And just imagine carrying 20 litres of kerosene up and down those steps every day. I guess those fellas will be rather pleased when it's all over and they're on to the electricity. Well, now let's move on to our next story.